how do we support people to make an informed choice about their immune health in the midst of all the information about vaccination and otherwise? Well, I think we start first by recognizing that if people are concerned about the safety of the vaccine or the way in which the community they represent might be unfairly treated when it comes to the vaccine, we have to recognize that all of that comes from a real body of medical trauma. And we're not trying to coerce people into a particular choice. Again, we want to support them to make an informed choice. And here's a choice, right, that nobody has to disagree about. And that's the impact of having the right information and knowing how to support your immune health no matter what. What are the things that go into immune health? What we eat. This is one of the core issues around providing your body with the nutrients it needs, both the calories, the protein, and the other supplements to make sure we have a strong immune system. Making sure we have rest, because in rest and in sleep is when our body does a lot of immune work. Vitamins that create supplements like vitamin C, zinc, and vitamin D, those three in particular are really important to having a strong immune system. Staying hydrated so that all our organs get the blood flow that they need. Doing your best to manage the way stress is showing up in your life and in your body. Because when you stay chronically stressed with high levels of stress hormones, you literally shut down and turn down your immune system. And then being careful to keep hygiene, again, things like clean hands and a clean body. If you have chronic health conditions, doing your best to manage those all help. All of that is stuff that anybody can do, regardless of their thought about the vaccine. And I find this to be a very powerful first place to start when talking to people about informed choice, because it's something we can all agree about. There is no replacement for ongoing physical distance covering and again, hygiene, because the truth is you won't get the disease if you don't get the infection. If the infection is prevented by a physical barrier, then again, that's something we can all agree on. This is how we can support an informed choice.